I have to say a few words regarding that educating the next generation in Sanatan Dharma. Some of the points I have written. Sanatan Dharma, everybody has explained it, that it is nothing but ancient qualities. Dharma is, it has come from the word dharan, and it has come from dharana. Dharana is perception. Perception of our qualities. Whatever perceptions we have got, those have to be firm, and those are to be ancient. So first of all, Sanatan Dharma symbolizes the ancient ethics, qualities, and morals. Let us concentrate on the basic issue of application of ancient culture. Few things need to be taught to every child right from the primary stage. Number one is human values in place of the material values. Let us not tell him ki this TV costs $100 and this car costs so much dollars, but how much is our human values are there in this person. He has got so many qualities. This person has got so many qualities. These are to be taught. Thrust on our virtuous feelings and thoughts. Feelings are more important. Thoughts are more important for us rather than anything else. We may or may not be knowing physics, chemistry, maths, bio, anything else, but we should not know the virtuous feelings. How we think. Let us think about ourselves. What we are thinking, that is more important. To see ourselves in everyone and feel the presence of everyone in the self. Har ek mein dusre mein dekhna, dusre ko dekhna, dusre mein apne aap ko dekhna, as in Bhagavad Gita 6:30. That yo mam pashyati sarvatra, sarvam cha maya pashyati tasyam na pranishyami, sacha na pranishyami, pranishyati. So attachment, two things. Whole of Bhagavad Gita is based on two things only, attachment and aversion. If you read from the right, from the first chapter to the 18th chapter, all the 700 shlokas, only through two things, attachment and aversion. This is to be taught to the children. And attachment is more harmful than the aversion. Attachment is so harmful ki hume ye aadmi bahut achha lagta hai. That is more harmful. Everybody is equal. At one time, I may behave in one way. At another time, I may behave in another way. But all are equal. Nobody is above. Nobody is below. Everybody is equal. This is to be taught to everybody. All of us are the eternal fragments of our super soul. This has to be taught from the very primary stage. And we may give the name of the God anything. Everybody is one. This everybody says, you may say it Christ, you may say it Rama, it is Krishna, anybody it can be. It should be taught from the right, from the beginning. There is no difference. Whatever perception I have got about the God, he is the God. That should be taught. Gurukul practice should be adopted everywhere. Mamai vanshe jeev loke sarabhut sanadana. So this teaching should be given. Then whenever we meet some person, I don't know where from this word hello has come. I don't know. Hello has come from somewhere. As far as I have read, Graham Bell, when he invented that telephone, this was the first word he told. Hello. I don't know what is the meaning of hell or what is the meaning of ho. And we are continuously using the word hello. And this should be avoided, I think. And this should not be taught to anyone. Namaskar, namaya akar, I am bowing to your formation. Whatever the God is in within you, I am bowing to that. And namaya tau, namaya te, sayatau te, everybody knows the Sanskrit scholars are there. Namastau, we don't know, use maximum of time. But when two persons we meet, namaya tau. When number of persons are there, then we have to say namaste. And we are using namaste everywhere. I say you are one person and we say namaste. That is not the practice. Aham namami. Main aapke aage jhukta hun. I bow to you. And touching feet. Touching feet is so pious that bowing keeps our blood circulation, keeps backbone and belly in order, in shape. That should be there. And this should be like, this practice should come up again. Touching feet transfers positive energy of the enlightened person to the that who touches it. Wishing goodness is fructified when we pass it on to with deep emotions. Emotions are more important. Anything else is not important. How much gratitude, how much emotions are there inside us, that is more important. This should be taught to the children from the right beginning. When you bow before that, it should, emotions should come from within yourself. Keeping ill feelings and wishing heavens malign our own mind and reflects in the form of the diseases. So many diseases are coming up here, I don't know, but in India there are so many because of only maligned attitude. We, whatever we think inside, we try to show other things to the other. We don't tell our truth inside. Emotions are more significant than the physical postures. Namaskar karna utna important nahi hai, jitna aapke andar se feeling generate hona jaruri hai. That is more important. And why it should be taught? Just two, three lines, I'll conclude. This knowledge is essential for the children, for the good, for to be good human beings, with one firm opinion in mind that the whole inhabitants of the earth are family, most of the people have already known, Vasudev Kutumbakam. So this small action in spirit will dissolve all the inter-country borders. One day, the whole earth will be one family. Just a minute, I just want to tell one thing, that the day when the Americans will start thinking on the lines of Abraham Lincoln. Abraham Lincoln was defeated 17 times here in America, as far as I have heard. It was like that. After 17 defeats, he could become the president of America. And what did he do? North America and South America. Till that date, how many years? 500 years. And this is one state. Can't it be all the borders cannot be abolished? Can't we think of a world where there will be no borders and there will be no border security forces? And what type of that earth will be? Just imagine that time, that if that thing is there, then it should be, and there will be no boundaries in the country and the earth will be a better place to live. And Vasudev Kutumbakam, that will not be a dream, it will be a reality. Thank you very much.